We went up that night, and Mike and I, Larry was already up there. So, Dave, what we did, we got all our stuff together, Mike and I, and I came home from work, and we started out, got in the car, got all our stuff. We had it all ready to go. We got in the car and we left. And it was a miserable night. Boy, was it miserable.
When the hills let go, so they fade into the water like some ancient lover on a ship filled with ghosts. It's something to behold. Twisting little braids in their hair, they take off their coats and throw pebbles and stones from the side of the boat, crying out. Stones they flow, stones they flow. Oh my God, stones they flow, stones they flow.
Finally got to the cottage. Larry's in there freezing. He says there's no heat in here, so I got the checking the furnace. Then I started up and it worked real pretty good.
Down a burning road, past the places where the steel beam meets concrete sky, and make your bed under the moonlight. Think it's time we said goodbye. There's nothing moves in the warm air. The words that once would cut like a knife, they just hang in the cloud. And you're pushed by the Lord, but you're pulled by the crowds. And you're overboard, you're overboard. Oh my God, she's overboard.
I fell asleep. Before you know it, the alarm went off. I heard Mike jumping around like crazy, getting his stuff ready and getting this and getting that. I said, "Hey, Mike, take it easy. I'm still sleeping." So about 4 o'clock, I get up. So I went ahead, Dave, and I got the home fries and the bacon and eggs and what have you. And I got it all on the stove. And I got stuff cooking, and we had a good breakfast. Finally, we had a good breakfast. I had your rifle, by the way, Dave. I had your rifle, and boy, I'll tell you, that's a rifle. 30-06 Remington. 3-9 fire scope, duplex. What a rifle, what a scope. Wow. The best.
There's neither shallow and broken in the valley where my heart ache and the timbers lay. It's not the time to be hanging around here. You know what some might say. People get too reckless, that even with the simplest of crime, they leave blood behind. As I clean the knife for the very last time, I think she knows, I think she knows. Oh my God, I think she knows, I think she knows.
So it was cold hell that morning. As the guy said, it wasn't cold, but to me, Dave, it was colder than hell. It was cold. I'm sitting there, and finally I got a real good spot. I got a log right next to me. I got a good rifle shot, you know. So, Dave, what happens? Here they come. Here comes deer. I get to shoot across the road, across the other ridge over. I saw one jumping up real high, up and down. You know how they jump. This boy, this one great big one. He was jumping up and down, jumping up and down. Here I saw this other one come up, and he looked right up at me, looked straight at me. So I picked the rifle up, I took a bead, put it on 7 power, chest shot.
shot.
That deer fell. So I waited and waited and waited, and they all took off. I waited and waited for about 15 minutes or so. So then I took off down over the woods. It was a good 80 to 100 yard shot. Here the deer was laying there. I said, well, I finally got my doe. That's the doe I shot.